Hello from API Video. Today I'm going to show you how to use refresh tokens. This is for when you want to use Python, but you've opted not to use our Python client. So if you do that, you do have to manage your own tokens. And with API Video, the access token will expire every hour, at which point you need to get a new one. There's two ways you can do that. You can either send in your API key and get another token, or you can go ahead and get yourself another access token using your refresh token if you've saved it. And this is safer because you don't have to expose your API key, and if someone gets the refresh token, there's not a lot they can do. They could use a token maybe for up to an hour, and you would be able to cancel that by getting yourself a new refresh token if you suspected that that had happened. Or if you really want, you could reset everything. So let's go over the sample really quick. It's pretty easy on the imports. We're just going to import requests, and then we're going to, in here, I'm just setting the URL equal to the endpoint for getting an access token, because for the sample, we have to get the access token, retrieve the refresh token, and then show the refresh token being used. So this is the setup for that. We have to add our API key, so let's go ahead and retrieve it from our dashboard. I'm going to use the production API key, so I just copied that. I'm going to go in here, and of course you can regenerate these if you want. For example, this will be compromised after this. So I'm going to go ahead and put that in here. And then I'm setting up my headers. To start with, all you need is to say that it's application JSON that we're sending and accepting. So I'm going to go ahead and send my payload that has my API key, my headers, to the URL that I set up, and get the response back in JSON. I'm going to be getting back a big set of, well, it's not that big a set of info. I guess I get back an access token, a refresh token, and some details about the token that I just got. So for this, now I'm going to retrieve the refresh token out of there, and then I print it so you guys can see it. And then the second part is now my access token has expired, and now I want to use the refresh token to get a new one. So I've saved it as token here, so I'm going to go ahead and set up my endpoint again, refresh token. I set up the payload, hey, I'm sending in this token. Headers are the same. The request is set up pretty much the same way, it's just different payload now and different endpoint. I'm going to get my response, and then I can print out my response and see what it is. It's going to be the same as what we just saw for the other access token section. Okay, let's go ahead and run this now. And there we go. So we printed out the refresh token the first time, and then we printed out the response the second time. So this is the complete response. It's a long, you can see there's the refresh token here, and then you can see the access tokens here. It tells me when my new access token's gonna expire. It's 3,599 seconds here. Normally that would be 3,600 seconds, which is 1 hour. And you can see in the first one, that I asked it to print just the token, so it's printing out the token there. And that is how you use refresh tokens. And that's how you refresh a token. Thanks for tuning in.